This one's called Paper Chase.
Paper Chase.
And this is a takeoff of from what my husband and I went through after Katrina with our piles and piles of paperwork from insurance companies and FEMA trailer papers and such.
The frustrations of FEMA, is that what you're saying?
I call it limbo, paper chase limbo.
Very cool.
So the shapes that are rectangular and kind of flimsy flying around are the papers that seem to never be endlessly come in and out and into the file and out again.
And into the vast abyss after it leaves your painting,
for
right?
For years after, too. Not just months, but years.
It's just really great. I love it. But it's set against that background, which is so fresh and revival. It's like, you know, whether you think of it as roadways or whether you think it's a wonderful awning stripe, just really, really attractive. And then you've got it mounted, you framed. And talk about the mounting in the frame a little bit.
It is a Cassine painting mm-hmm. on watercolor paper.
Okay.
So it needs to be protected. It's behind glass, and it's been custom framed by myself. Okay. I pick out my own frames, I order them, and mount them myself, because I really have in mind what I want around them. I even painted the gold around the edge to go with the gold that's in the
gold on the frame. Yeah, but then putting that stark black bat really brings out the colors and the whole subject matter. So that was great. Sometimes people want to go, you know, coordinate it together, but I think in this particular painting was well to give the contrast. I really like that a lot.